Better tell a love story now, because you have background material on me. This occurred before I was married. A long time ago in Manhattan. I was in Manhattan. I was at City Center. This was ages ago. I was watching a ballet at City Center. And I'm not a ballet fan at all, but they were doing The Dying Swan. And there was a rumor that some bookmakers had drifted into town from upstate New York and that they had fixed the ballet. Apparently there was a lot of money bet on the swan to live. And I look in the box and I see a girl. And my weak spot is women. And so I always think someday they're going to make me a birthday party and wheel out a tremendous birthday cake and a giant naked woman is going to leap out of the cake and hurt me and leap back in. And I'm gonna... So I pick up this girl. I was very glib. She was a brilliant girl. She was a Bennington girl, studying at Bennington to be a woman male nurse in a four-year program, working on a term paper on the increasing incidence of heterosexuality amongst homosexuals. The girl was a swinger, however, I must... The girl was brought up in Darien, Connecticut. And when she was younger, she had a little brother, about 6 years old, 8 years old, and the parents sent the kid to military school. And while he was there, he stole jam or something, and they caught him. And they wanted to do things right, because it was military school. So they held a court-martial there. They found the kid guilty, and they shot him. They returned to his parents half the tuition. And meanwhile, I was running amok with his sister. His sister was fabulous. She was a great, great blonde, and she had tattooed on the inner surface of her thigh the words "bird lives," which unfortunately I was never privileged to see in the relationship, but had it been printed in Braille, I would have had a great thing going with that. We used to go up to her apartment late at night, and all her beatnik friends would be sitting cross-legged on each other there, and they'd be trying to make opium out of poppies given out by veterans on street corners. To plug in a $12.50 hi-fi set, you know, with the teak wood needle, and put on the record albums of Marcel Marceau, you know, just... She crushed me. Every time I tell this story, I'm reminded, I was what you would call, I guess, not intellectually up to her. She was, well, I was thrown out of college, and when I was thrown out of college, I got a job on Madison Avenue in New York. A real dyed-in-the-wool advertising agency on Madison Avenue wanted a man to come in, and they pay him $95 a week, and to sit in their office and to look Jewish. They wanted to prove to the outside world that they would hire minority groups, you know. So I was the one they hired, you know. I was the show Jew with the agency. I tried to look Jewish desperately, you know. Used to read my memos from right to left all the time. They fired me finally because I took off too many Jewish holidays.